and welcome. Chris Fowler, Kirk Herbstreit, Samantha Ponder will join us on a wintry night here in Morgantown. Already, it has been feisty, Kirk. You were on the field pregame. This is what happened as the Sooners made their way over to that Mountaineer logo, began to jump up and down, and the guys in blue did not like it.
No, there's a little bit of history here going back to even last year when Oklahoma and West Virginia got together. Look at this. I mean, it was a melee. These guys are getting, obviously, after one another. I was down on the field before this, and you could see some of the wide receivers from West Virginia kind of jawing at the Oklahoma defensive backs. Baker Mayfield at the end of that trying to say, hey, let's just go out and play ball. But, yeah, emotions are high. There's a lot at stake for both these teams. What are they saying? The biggest home game here in Morgantown in, what, 23
years.
Yeah, so this is a big-time game tonight.
With 14 straight Big 12 wins. And they have won 10 true road games in a row. Two colorful coaches tonight. This will be fun, Kirk. West Virginia won the toss deferred, so Sooners will get the ball first. And we'll see Mayfield go to work. Mike Molina to kick it away for the Mountaineers. Joe Mixon and Dede Westbrook are deep. It's a short kick. One of the up men. And it is fumbled out of bounds. And Sooners will take over at the 24, and here is Mayfield. Kirk, you talked about how well he's been playing lately.
Yeah, the last 7 weeks, playing as well as anybody in the country. In fact, his passing efficiency is outstanding. He's got to take care of the ball, obviously, tonight in these conditions. Improvise, keeping plays alive with his feet, and also when he gets his opportunity, because of such great balance and the way they can run the ball with Samaje Perine and Joe Mixon, Dede Westbrook right now, last 7 weeks, probably not a hotter wide receiver. When they get some one-on-one chances downfield, he's got to hit number 11.
Mayfield here from Austin, Texas. He's played in cold weather before, including some Bedlam games when it's typically pretty frosty in the state of Oklahoma. Perine, the big 235-pounder, is the back. Feed it to him. And Perine, healthy. Missed almost four games, Kirk, but he's fresh now, and he rips off 12 on the first play. Yep. So two dropped for the Sooners. And Austin Seifert, who handles the punting and the place kicking, boots it away. It's a short punt, bouncing around down there. Now it's muffed, a scrum, a mistake as the Mountaineers tried to field the ball, and Oklahoma's got it. Sam Grant recovered the fumble. Special teams obviously going to be impacted on this wintry night, and the mistake by the Mountaineers sets Oklahoma up at the 34.
Yeah, poor decision here. You know, I don't know if Jennings thought that Kyrum, the ball may have touched him. See, Jennings reacts because 14 right there. I don't know if he thought it may have hit his foot that made him go after the football. See, right there, I think he thinks, oh, that ball might have hit one of my guys. I got to go get the ball. And obviously, in these conditions, that's the last thing that you want to do.
Joe Mixon is to the left of Mayfield. He's got it. And Mixon picks his way inside the 30. And now they'll back up out of the shotgun on third and one. Mountaineers crowd the middle. Mixon tries to get wide and does escape. Mixon down the sideline, barrels to a first and goal at the 5.
Here early in this game, what I'm seeing is Oklahoma in the running game is able to get to the edge. And the reason is you're seeing a lot of man-to-man on the outside, and you're playing at 3-3-5. If he can outrun that linebacker, Arndt, there's nobody left on the perimeter. Good job here early in this game from Lincoln Riley being able to get the ball to the edge. There's West Virginia trying to send a message again. A little push there from David Long into the face of Mixon. This is where Baker Mayfield, in normal conditions, his feet, his ability to create and run can always be dangerous. Now he's actually going to motion out. Nobody's out there with him. And now they move out.
It's Perine in direct snap formation. He's got it. Big fella barreling downhill. Cannot be stopped. Touchdown, Oklahoma, as they cash in the muff punt and draw first blood.
Talk about some leg drive here. How about Benton, number 3, meets him right before the goal line. See number 3 right there? Thinks he has him stopped. There's that lower body strength and the leg drive that pushes him into the end zone. Well, that's a heck of a collision there. It gives you an idea, again, of the strength of Perine. He got across for the touchdown.
And Howard looks near side. High throw, hard hit, incomplete. Dekeel Shorts, the slot receiver, was hammered by Stephen Parker, incomplete.
Great reaction by Parker there. That ball was thrown a long way from the left hash. all the way over to this boundary. Pretty good effort there by Shorts to go up and make the play. But this Oklahoma secondary has been challenged all week by Mike Stoops, the defensive coordinator, and Bob Stoops to make plays on the ball.
Howard steps up, delivers from the pocket, almost intercepted. Had a chance to make a play right there. And that's Jordan Evans, the leader of this defense, the senior backer, had it right in his hands.
Boy, watch him do a great job of reading the eyes. Completely sits right where he needs to be. The quarterback led him there.
Empty backfield for Mayfield. And the Mountaineers bring some pressure, gets it out quickly, complete. Look out, Westbrook can fly, escapes. D.D. Westbrook does not lose foot races. Touchdown, Oklahoma. 75 yards.
But you're going to see Oklahoma do a good job of getting their linemen out. They're not worried about that pressure because the ball is going to get out so quickly. And once the ball gets out, you've got a lineman downfield, the big tight end, Mark Andrews also. But that's the thing that's impressive to me. We're used to seeing Westbrook go by people with double moves and just strictly the vertical passing game. But this time, he makes a catch. He's trying to just get the first down. But right there, stiff arm, and then to be able to just throw the linebacker down.
Yeah.
And then take it all. You know, of course, he has a speed to take it to the house.
Mayfield, that's one of his more restrained reactions to a touchdown pass. But Westbrook with his 15th touchdown. Now he gets going. That's what we're used to seeing.
Yeah, there he is.
Yeah.
I don't think he can believe that he just saw D.D. Westbrook throw a middle linebacker down. He was in awe.
His 15th touchdown reception of the season ties a single season school record. And the crowd is completely out of it. They were booing West Virginia the last series. Westbrook in motion. They fake it to him. Here goes Joe Mixon. It's maybe his turn to get involved now. He gets 10.
The offensive line is just dominating the line of scrimmage.
And they get increased again. It's a defense, Kirk, that played more than 100 snaps a week ago against Texas and the Heat in Austin.
Because the goal here is to get the Pirine and Mixon before they build up momentum.
Mayfield rolling out on second down. Sets his feet, fires over the middle, and wide open is Westbrook. He'd leave him alone, and Westbrook still bouncing around. Again, Kirk showing the toughness to go with that world-class speed. Moves it to the 35.
Well-designed play. You're running the ball. You're running the ball. You boot away. Nobody's even thinking about D.D. Westbrook. Clearly way back on the backside. Look how soft the coverage is there from Douglas. And there he is fighting again for more yards.
Two catches, 100 yards. They're trying to rip his head off there after the catch. Yeah. Westbrook is pumped up playing the Mountaineers. He wears number 11 to honor Tavon Austin, of course, the former Mountaineer great, who had a monster game against Oklahoma. Remember that game
in
2012, was it?
Yeah.
Bouncing free again is Mixon.
They're pulling these guards and tackles and just pushing people around. Great patience by Joe Mixon, letting the big fellas get around. Then Powers, Orlando Brown. They come around. Orlando Brown, 7'8", 6'8", 340 pounds.
But you don't want to meet him when he does, do you?
No.
Mixon again, lowers the head, and they move the sticks one more time. Here's that Sooner offensive line. You got a couple sophomores and a freshman up there.
I think, again, this is the area probably that they've improved the most from where they were against Houston and Ohio State. But as you can see tonight, continuity is there.
Around the center is the only senior. Mixon again, breaks a tackle, barrels into the secondary, twists down to the five, and the Sooners are threatened to blow this wide open now.
This looks like a sieve right now with what Oklahoma's doing to this West Virginia. Watch the offensive line. Great block by the fullback, Flowers. That's actually what opened it up there for him.
High snap, Mayfield pulls it down, keeps it, throws in the end zone, touchdown. Wide open is Jeffrey Meade.
So you're running the counter, you're running the counter, you're going to pull the counter, you're going to run the football this way, right? Well, that's what the defense thinks. What a time for this. Look at the defense flying over here, and all you're going to do is come to the backside right there for an easy touchdown. That just sets up perfectly off the play action look. The counter, the inside zone, and then the counter play action with the exact same look, pulling the guard and the tackle. Linebackers fire in.
Report, Sam, Mrs. Crawford. Olasky is a pure Cleveland guy, a senior, like a lot of centers. He's a smart football player, but also a colorful guy.
Nice throw that time. Made it very easy for White to make the play.
And now Crawford barrels ahead, loses the ball, and the Sooners fall on it. Just when West Virginia looked like they were getting back in the game, the ball was stripped by Jordan Evans, and a second West Virginia turnover. There's still a scrum down there. They battle for the ball. And Jordan, it looked like Oklahoma fell on it.
Jordan Parker, the freshman we were just talking about, the corner, looked like he got on top of the football, and he, in fact, comes up with it. But you're right, Chris. It was Jordan Evans, the leader in the middle, after a pretty significant gain again from Crawford. Right there, he's tackling the football. We were talking about that today on the bus on the Big 12. You see linebackers, safeties tackling the football more often than trying to actually form tackle a ball carrier. And that time it paid off for Evans as the ball came out.
And Crawford fumbled early in the game against Texas. Similar kind of play as they kind of ripped at the ball. Evans continues to be just a terrific playmaker in this defense. And now Perine, they're backed up in the goal line, but quickly moved the sticks again with a power run to the far side.
And they just are going on the edge again.
Mixon bounces, breaks it free, spins into West Virginia territory, and is hauled down at the 45. You hold your breath when he's got the football.
Yeah, they're going to run a counter. The center's going to pull. Flowers is going to come around. They've given him a lot of different looks. But what you got to love is there's nothing there. He's able to look here, and then he bounces there. That's something that, again, these backs have tremendous quickness, but it's the vision and the patience that make them so special.
Take it to Mixon. Mayfield flips it far side, and the catch is made by Meade, who had the touchdown catch. Now a flag comes in on the sideline where he's knocked out of bounds, and it's going to be another mental mistake on this defense. This feels like a knockout punch here if the Sooners can get in the end zone. Mixon again breaks the tackle. Joe Mixon barrels down to the 5-yard line. Good point. Mental and also very physical. And Mixon just walks into the end zone standing up, and the Sooners lowering the boom in Morgantown tonight with a big assist from that West Virginia defense and special teams. Two personal fouls.
The lateral quickness and the vision has been on display here, and great blocking up front by that offensive line and by the fullback, Dimitri Flowers. Boy, what a 1-2 punch with Mixon and Perine tonight.
That was one of the guys that got the seniors and the leaders on defense together after that embarrassing game against Tech, and demanded much more of them in practice and games, as Howard fumbles the snap and Oklahoma recovers. Another miscue in scoring position. Exactly what they did not need.
So they've been going shotgun, shotgun, and Dana Holgerson's losing his mind. Another turnover inside, deep inside Oklahoma territory. They've been going shotgun, right? Shotgun, all of a sudden it's third down. He gets under center. Gets under center and never gets the snap for Morlowski. Ball's down, Sooners jump on top of it.
And the Dana rage flashing there as you saw it. 28 zip, Sooners get the ball back. Perine breaking free. Perine scoots free. Big stiff arm barrels down the sidelines. Saw Mixon well over 100, and Perine's headed for the century mark as well. Perine again breaks some more tackles. He made a great point. They have now 233 rushing yards, most of them after contact. Absolutely. Westbrook's touchdown was after some contact. He broke free for a 75-yard reception.
Yeah.
In the pistol formation, Perine behind Mayfield. He's got it again, and Perine banging into the end zone, standing up, and Oklahoma builds the lead to 5 touchdowns.
Again, more yards after contact. Linebacker Benton got in there, but you'll see him run through. Watch three, trying to shoot a gap. He gets his right arm on him to try to slow him down, but he's trying to deal with a big fullback there in Flowers. Safety came over also with some speed, but he didn't wrap up. He just throws him off. Just a matter of them growing up. A lot of them are young players that haven't played a lot of football.
Howard on fourth down has a lot of time for the pocket. Picked off.
intercepted by Jordan Evans. The former high school running back got skills with the football, and he's got a clear path to the end zone. Can they catch him? No! Another pick six for the defensive leader for Oklahoma. 80 yards. And yet another Mountaineer miscue.
Well, watch him just read this. He reads the route first. See how he reads the route? He's looking, his eyes. All of a sudden, he's got his eyes on the quarterback. The quarterback, as we saw in the first half, brought him exactly where he needed to be to make a play on the football. But that was great route recognition. Saw the back slip out to the flat.
You're getting beat by five touchdowns. It's cold, it's windy, it's snowy. What are you going to do?
Why are you here?
Snuggle. Well, if you're going to stay, then snuggle.
Okay, but you're not even watching the game.
But they're still there.
Okay.
Unlike most of the folks who headed for the exits here. Durant from the goal line and knocked down at the 15-yard line. Salas says that they've been productive. They found creases in the Sooner defense.
Oh, yeah.
They made really big plays, especially Crawford.
There they go. There's a nice play. There's Neville Gallimore. It's the guy that Mike Stoops, a freshman, said that he is coming on, and he has a chance to really be a superstar up at the top. It's off the ball, does a good job of using his hands, throwing away the freshman McKivitz, makes a play in the backfield. And Shorts is more your option route guy underneath. Another nice play by that Oklahoma defensive front.
That's a loss for Crawford on third down.
Shot the linebacker here.
Parker cleaned it up.
And they shot a linebacker and also the safety. Hunter does a nice job. Stephen Parker, a guy that played a lot of football a year ago, and with the loss of those six leaders we talked about a little earlier, he's kind of become one of the guys.
Ha! Barely a forward pass, and Mixon makes his first catch of the night. He's really effective weapon out of the backfield as a receiver, and they move the sticks.
Yeah, nice little kind of a rub or a pick by Andrews, but it's a totally different feel now with him in that pocket.
He fires over there far side, and the catch is made by Geno Lewis. You mentioned him, the Penn State graduate transfer, and he moves the six.
See, his numbers are somewhat similar. I think it depends on if the Spartans show up and play with some energy. If they play the way they did against Ohio State today and Michigan a few weeks ago, they'll be in that football game with Penn State. Maybe they get in even before that.
Howard again takes off. That time they're ready for it, and he's dragged down by Emmanuel Beal, the junior linebacker.
Especially with Evans down, Beal's got to make plays. He'll come from our right, just chases Howard down from behind.
They come after Mayfield, who backpedals and delivers into traffic. It's a first down strike. Mixon breaks a tackle, stiff arm, and the Sooners finally have the running game going again down near the 30-yard line.
What I love about that is there are no tendencies. They could run right, they could run left. This time they run it to the left. P. Ryan this time is a lead blocker on the counter play, but they can run that just as easily to the left. Sometimes when there's just a one back, there's some tendencies.
Mayfield. Wanted to take a shot downfield, has all day to throw, just delivers underneath. And the catch is made by Geno Lewis, and he fights down inside the 15-yard line.
Boy, this gives you a great look at an experienced receiver just sitting right where he needs to and not panicking. Look out to your left right out here. Look how he just waits and just kind of sits there in the hole, and eventually, because of the protection up front.
Mayfield on the sneak. Trying to get a shove.
Oh, he's short.
Yeah, didn't get there. The third down. Flowers, the fullback, trying to shove him across, but that's just too much traffic.
Yeah, I don't. Well, now they give it to him. Huh.
That is the latest touchdown signal in history. They finally unpiled it.
Yeah, now they're talking. They want Baker Mayfield to stay out there.
I'll take another look at this. This is the most delayed
that was.
Signal I've ever seen.
But Dave Kataya ran down there and made the call for him. It took forever.
I mean, I guess there's a lot of guys to unpile.
I guess.
To get at number six there. They had about four blue jerseys to peel away.
And they did sort of get back, as you suggested. They got back on that drive to what was working earlier, the bread and butter plays.
Yep.
Westbrook in motion. Mayfield keeps it, fires end zone, and Andrews collects the two-point conversion as he comes across and beats Avery, the safety. And it is back to a 21-point lead.
What this win tonight will mean is that Oklahoma's sitting at 9, and everybody's saying that they wanted to see an impressive win on their resume.
And they'll go for their 10th Big 12 title. That would be more than all the other current members have combined. And Howard will be sacked.
Great coverage downfield.
And that will turn it back over. If it is Oklahoma, and we're not presuming they're going to beat the Cowboys. So you calm down, Oak State fans. I get it. As Herein takes off and tries to add another touchdown to his big night, hauled down inside the 10-yard line. Guy's never scored a touchdown in his career. This would cap it. And he's not going to get one there. It's Mayfield. Just pulls it and walks it. Give the young guy. Let him get in the scoring column. I mean, you don't. And as a runner, he's scored twice, including this one.
It's actually not a call for Baker Mayfield, just his own read. He read the end collapsing eight. The outside linebacker came down. He made the right read. He probably wanted to give it to the freshman more than anybody, but it was a walk-in with the read that he had, and he gets an easy score. And Oklahoma, after we showed that graphic, their first four drives in the second half were an interception and three punts. Mm-hmm. Since then, back-to-back touchdowns to close the door here in Morgantown. If anything, he played harder when they were in that big hole.
Howard spinning away. What's going to be the final play of the game? He fires it over the end zone. Third most rushing yards ever, by the way, for a Mountaineer. Tavon Austin has the record. Did it against Oklahoma. The Sooners start fast and furious against a mistake-prone West Virginia team, and they close strong, 56-28. Let's go to Samantha with Baker Mayfield.
Well, Baker, this one started really feisty. So describe to me why this one was so emotionally charged even before it started.
It's always chippy when you play them, and especially because it's just the physical type of game. They're a physical team. So there was a lot of chatter through social media stuff pregame and during the week. So it kind of got everybody riled up. And then pregame when both teams met in the middle, there's pushing and shoving. So it was just kind of that game. And we came out with that intensity, and we were able to execute early on.
So obviously early, the weather kind of dictated that you had to run the ball, but you were able to run the ball so well. What enabled the running game to perform that way?
Great offensive line. They're executing and they're playing well right now. And then obviously our running backs, two of the most talented guys in the country. So when you have them, might as well utilize them, hand it off to them. So I'm just here to win games. And if I'm handing it off, that's fine with me.
Baker, as you know, a lot of people wrote y'all off after those two early losses. Now people are talking playoff. You head into Bedlam this week. In your mind, is this team playing for a playoff spot?
We absolutely are. I think just the type of game we're playing right now, we're playing well. Defense is coming along. I mean, West Virginia is a good team, and we came into their stadium and won in a good way. So we're playing well. We just need to keep on making statements and just win the Big 12 and see what happens from there.
Last thing for you. I know you're a Texas boy. You ever played in weather like this?
Absolutely not. Maybe at recess or when they cancel school, but that's it.
Well, you did well. Congratulations on the win. Thanks, Baker.
Yeah, Mayfield, team guy. Obviously, a Heisman contender, didn't have the kind of passing numbers you'd expect would help his case. Doesn't care about that because it's going to be the Sooners and the Cowboys in the Bedlam series in a couple of weeks for the Big 12 championship and playoff consideration.
And that game is always so much fun every year, and especially when there's that much at stake. And for fans in that state, I know they always hope that it comes down to Bedlam, and this year they get their wish.
All right, now none of the top four lost, but do you reshuffle any of yours? And
no, I think I still have Alabama, obviously, at one. And Ohio State and Michigan, they'll work that out this Saturday in Columbus. And Clemson sitting there, for me, you know, they'll move up. If Clemson keeps winning, they're going to be in the playoff if they win the ACC. And they got a game with South Carolina, rivalry game. But, yeah, that's my four right now as we get ready for this.
First team out, is it the Huskies? Did the Sooners get consideration? Is it another Big Ten
Sooners
team?
Sooners get consideration. You know, I would say that Wisconsin is there. You also would have to put Washington there. We'll see if Washington survives Friday when they take on Washington State in the Apple Cup.
Final takeaway. We knew Oklahoma had a huge offense. There's still some defensive concerns, though, heading into the last game off what they did tonight here.
At the very least, you would expect that to be a shootout. A lot of points. Both those quarterbacks and both those offenses, at least going into the game, you would think would have a big game.
Well, Mayfield said that it was social media that set the stage for the feistiness. They blame something else on social media. When they got to football, it was West Virginia not able to handle the conditions or the emotions as well as Oklahoma. And the Sooners go on the road and take care of business 56-28 tonight here in snowy Morgantown. The game was produced by Bill Bunnell, directed by Derek Mobley. A salute to our crew who battled these tough conditions tonight. We thank you for watching from Morgantown. I invite you to watch College Game Day from Columbus at 7 a.m. Eastern. And then Wolverines and the Buckeyes on ABC at noon Eastern next Saturday. The Ford Wrap-Up Show right now, and to Cassidy Hubbard.